Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to study two important commands in Linux, tar and grep. So before starting our tutorial, I will log into my CentOS machine. Okay, we have logged into our machine. Now we will start our today's tutorial, which includes two commands, tar and grep. First of all, we will look for tar command. So what is tar command? For what purpose it is used? Okay, tar is a tape archive command. So long form of tar is a tape archive command. For what purpose it is used? Basically, it is used to create archive files. What are archive files? Archive files are nothing but files which contains more than one files into a single file. Just in Windows you are using zip files. Okay, what are zip files? This contains a compressed files, number of compressed files together into a single file. Like a zip utility in Windows, we have tar utility in Linux. Basically, this tar utility is used for taking backups. Okay, this tar utility is used to take a backups. So we'll look into man page for more information about tar utility. So I will fire man command on my terminal to look for more information about tar utility. So man tar, you will find a manual page for tar command. See, GNU tar saves many files into a single tape or a disk archive. Okay, single tape or disk archive, and can restore individual files from the archive. Okay, what this means? Basically, this tar command is used to take a backup. So how we are going to create this tar file? So we'll look how to create this tar file, which will contain number of different files compressed together. Okay, so how to create this tar file? You will find how to use this tar command. See, synopsis tar, you will have to provide options and then the name of file. Okay, so in example they have provided you how to create a tar file. See, tar minus cf archive.tar, it's a name of file, tar file that we want to create, and foo and bar, these are the files which we want inside our archive file. So it is as good as this archive.tar file contains foo and bar files. So this archive.tar is a backup for foo and bar, I can say. So I can just take backup of this archive.tar on my external device, and later on when I want to restore these files, I will just need to restore these files from the archive.tar file, because these two files are collected together into archive.tar file. Okay, so minus c option you can use with f option. Same way, if you want to list files which are present inside archive file, you will have to use tar minus tf and name of archive file. That will list down the files which are present inside your archive.tar file. Same way, if you want to extract files, okay, you have tar file and you want to extract that tar file, you can use option tar minus except archive.tar. If you will go below in man page, you will find the meaning of different options. For example, we have looked just right now minus c option, which is to create an archive file. Then we have looked minus x option, which is to extract file. Then we have looked minus T option, which lists the contents of an archive file. And we have looked minus V option, which is used to display the files which are being currently processed. So we will now see practical demonstration how to create a tar file. So I will quit with Q key on keyboard from this manual page. Now we are on terminal. So before creating tar file, I will create three files with touch command inside current directory. So I will fire touch command, then I will create one.txt file. Sorry, I made a mistake. Txt file. Then I will create another text file, touch 2.txt. Then I will create another text file, one touch 3.txt. I will create one more directory inside our present directory. Let us name it as ABC. Okay, now I will show you these files and directories that I have created in my present working directory. What is my present working directory? I will show you first of all what is my present working directory with pwd command. It's a home directory, my home directory /home/Atul. Okay, I will show you now the files created and directory created inside my present working directory with ls command. So you can see I have 1.txt file, 3.txt file, 2.txt file and abc directory which I have created right now. Now I want to create an archive file, okay, and inside that archive file I want backup of 1.txt, 2.txt, 3.txt and this abc directory which we have created right now. So how to create this archive file? Using tar command. Tar, then I will provide the names of I will provide options. -c is to create archive file, v to display output on terminal, that is verbose, f to create file. Then I will have to provide name of tar file which I want to create. Let us give it a name as sat.tar. Then provide the name of files which you want to be part of this archive file. So I will use tar.txt to include all text files which are present inside current working directory. What this tar stands for? Tar means all files which have extension .txt. Then also I want to include a directory abc, so I will mention that also here. Now I will press enter. So you can see it has displayed me this output, 1.txt, 2.txt, 3.txt and abc directory. What this means is this command has successfully completed and it has created sat.tar file which includes these files. Okay, so I will show you inside my present working directory that sat.tar file is created with ls command. So ls command I have fired and you can see sat.tar file is present inside my current directory. Now let me delete this 1.txt, 2.txt and 3.txt files and abc directory from my current directory. So to delete these files I will have to use rm command and *.txt. Okay, to remove directory I will use rmdir command and name of directory. I will also delete abcd directory, okay, which is present inside my abc directory is not empty. Okay, it has removed abc directory, but abcd directory is not empty, it's saying. We can remove that forcefully with rm minus rf forcefully remove and recursively remove abcd. So now I will fire ls command. You will see only set.tar file is present. Okay, inside my present working directory. Now what I will do? I will show you what files are present inside set.tar file. That means I am going to list down the contents of sat.tar file. We have looked into main page, the command, options available with tar command to list down the contents of tar file is -t option. So we will use that with tar -tvf, and then we have to provide the name of tar file sat.tar. It will list down the contents of sat.tar file, means these files are present inside sat.tar file. Now what we will do, we will extract these files, okay, from sat.tar file. I will show you contents of current directory ls with ls command. You can see currently there are no contents, there are no files 1.txt or 2.txt or 3.txt or abc directory is present inside my present working directory. Now I am going to extract these directories from sat.tar file with tar command. So we have looked into main page and we found that option that is available to extract the contents of tar file is a -xf option. So we will use that tar -x to extract, v for verbose, f for file. Then we have to provide the name of file sat.tar. Now it will extract these above files from sat.tar file. So when I press enter, it will show me that these files are extracted. Okay, so we will just verify whether these files are extracted from sat.tar file with ls command. So I will fire ls command on terminal. So it will show me that inside my present working directory 1.txt, 2.txt, 3.txt and abc directory is extracted from sat.tar file. So this is the usage of tar command. Basically tar is the same like your zip utility in Windows, which is used to compress or collect different files into a single file, which is used basically to take backups. So later on you can extract the files from this zip file. Okay, this is sufficient for I think tar command. Next we will see is a grep command. Okay, now we will start our demonstration for grep command. Let me clear my screen with the clear command. Okay, so what is a grep command and what purpose it is used, we will look first and then we will go for practical demonstration of grep command. So grep is a global regular expression pattern, and this command is used for searching particular pattern or particular string or particular word whether it's present inside a file or not. Okay, so basically this grep utility is used to search for presence of pattern inside files. So this pattern can be a word or it can be a string or it can be some other things which are present inside file or not. So grep is like a search. Okay, so how to use it for this purpose, I will create one file, text file. Okay, so I will create a vi, let us give it a name as abc.txt file, and inside this file I will type some words. Let us say hello. Sorry, it's a vi editor. First of all, to start working with vi editor, or before starting to type inside vi editor, you need to press i key to enter into insert mode. It's right now below showing insert. Okay, so I'll have to press I key. Once I press I key, it will allow me to write inside this VI editor. So I am starting to write inside this file, hello world, welcome to Linux programming, hello, how are you? Where are you from? Sorry for mistakes. Hello. Okay, I have typed 5 lines. Okay, I will save this file. So for saving, you will have to press escape key followed by colon and then W key. Means write and quit. So we have created one abc.txt file. I will show you the contents of abc.txt file. See, if you are not comfortable with this VI editor, you can go for nano editor. It's a nice and light editor as compared to VI editor. Also, you can go with gedit editor, choice is yours. So you can see the contents of my abc.txt file. Now with grep utility, we will try to find out whether hello world is present inside abc.txt file or not. So before using grep command, we will look man page of grep so that we will get idea how to use this grep utility. So man grep, you can see what this utility does. Print lines matching pattern. So what this does, if it will print the lines matching particular pattern which you have provided. For example, in our case, we are going to search hello word inside our abc.txt file. So what is expected output? It should show me the lines, all lines which contains hello word. Then you can see options of this command. We will not go in much details with options, but let me show you this minus c option is counts how many times that particular word or pattern is present inside that particular file. We will use that one also, and then we will use minus n option, where it is line numbering. For line numbering, at what line numbers inside your files particular pattern is present, that's the usage of minus n. You can try other options also on your own. Okay, you can refer this manual page. So it's really easy to use other options. So if you will go through man page, we will just use a minus C option and minus N option. So I will quit this man page with a Q key. Okay, now I will try to find hello world, whether it's present inside abc.txt file, and if present, it will print the lines. Okay, all lines which contains hello world. So okay, grep. Let me show you how to use this again, once again with synopsis. Man grep, you will have to provide grep options, then you will have to mention pattern, what you are looking for and where you are looking for is a file. Okay, Q. So grep, right now we will not use any option. Okay, we want to search hello world inside abc.txt file. Okay, so see, it has printed 3 lines from abc.txt file which contains hello world. You can see here, so hello world is present inside abc.txt file. If we are searching for a particular word and if that word is not present inside abc.txt file, it will not show you output. So we will try to find out one word www. It's not present inside abc.txt file. So see, it has not returned me any output. That means this particular word is not present inside abc.txt file. Got it? So what grep utility does, it looks for pattern which you have supplied to it and it tries to find out matching lines inside that particular file which you have provided. So in our case, we have supplied it a pattern as a hello word, and our grep utility search for hello word inside abc.txt file and it returned me back the lines inside abc.txt file which contains hello word. So in our case, there are three lines which contain hello word. Now how many times this hello word is present inside abc.txt file, we can find that also with grep command. So how to find that? Grep, then I will have to supply option minus c, which we have looked into main page of grep utility. Then what we want to look for? Hello inside abc.txt. So how many times this word is present? Three times. So it should return me three output. So you can see three is returned me because this word is present inside abc.txt file three times. Okay, next we'll print the line numbers. Okay, line numbers where this hello word is present. So what we will do, we'll use grep command, then we have seen minus n option, then we will have to supply what we want to look for, a hello word inside what? abc.txt file. So you can see these are the line numbers. Hello word is present at line number 2, then it is present at line number 4 and line number 6. So you can see this. So first was a blank line, then second line hello word is present, then fourth line and then sixth line. So this is how you can use grep utility to look for particular pattern or particular word, whether it's present inside file or not. Okay, so that's all for today, friends. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel, please press bell icon and please like and share this video if you like it. Thanks a lot.